We are down at the Barrow Pit. We're gonna catch some fish. What is it, about a quarter to 7 a.m.? Yep. Something like that. But I didn't catch any fish on the first cast, and that kind of makes me mad.
I hear that's bad luck.
Well, over at the church the day that I did that, I caught like 7, and 2 of them were back-to-back 2-pounders, so, you know. I wasn't complaining. Got one on. Man, he's been beat up. He's a pretty fish. Alright, I'm gonna let you go. I'm gonna let you go. Where you at? I see you. Now I just want to show you what's up with him. Just want to show you what's up with him.
Got marks on him?
No, this is how I caught him. I didn't do that to him.
Oh yeah, the gill ripped out. Someone caught him before.
Yep. Here you go, buddy. Thanks for biting. Yep. Yes, sir. I thought you had one. I saw that little thing laying down there. Want to do a challenge? Starting right now?
Yep. What are we doing?
Whoever catches the first fish, forget about the one I've already got down there, but whoever catches the first fish gets to choose what the other person fishes with, lure wise. Out of
category, yeah.
Out of each other's tackle.
Okay, yeah.
I mean, I'm not going to fish with yours, but you're gonna pick what I do, and yeah. The rod, the combo we use is up to us. But we just have to pick what, or use whatever bait we choose for each other. I already know what I'm gonna pick. I'm gonna pick that pretty bluegill, man. Have you used it yet?
Nuh-uh. I also got one that I'm about to bust out, a smaller one for the other rod.
Oh, I thought I had one, but that was just weeds. Me and Adam decided to do a little bit of fun fishing today. See what we can catch. He and I both caught big ones out of here. His is the only one that's been on camera. 5 pounds, 7 ounces.
Yep.
And that was Easter Sunday.
Yep. Right on Easter Sunday.
Yep. Because I went to church on Saturday to make room for people on a Sunday, Easter Sunday service. That was a good day. Did I cross you?
No.
You see this big bed over here?
Yeah, bluegill bed.
Yeah, it's huge.
There ain't nothing there now, though. Are there?
No, nothing at all. Well, I mean, there's a little... couple of little bait fish swimming across it. Maybe an inch or so long. All right, I'm gonna go to what's worked for me today. I'm gonna pick your bait, bro.
Definitely. If I keep fishing this, probably. Because if I get something on this, it's gonna be a decent one.
Well, I'm just hoping you would catch the first fish, because every time that you've picked my baits before, just playing around, I've caught fish on them. Gary and I were down here not long ago, and I'm gonna have to post that video here pretty quick too. We're over between that limb that's on the ground there and the beaver den, and we both caught two fish there. And you know, nothing that would make a big fish video at all. Just fish. I don't think I'm getting a bite here.
Right, draw the weightless.
Yeah. That's yep, I am getting a bite. Come on. Oh, guys, I know you're in here.
If they don't bite on a weightless, they're just...
Right. That was just weeds. Starting to feel good about myself there for a minute. But hey, does a grass bass count? Oh, maybe I was. Check it out. It feels so much like grass all the time anyway, though.
Yeah.
Sometimes the bass, no matter, I keep thinking that's a fish, man, every time I see it. Is that the tyrant?
Yep. This is the tyrant 10.
The tyrant 10? Ah, shit.
I know, I about had that happen to me. Hurry up and stop it with my thumb.
This is what happens when you think you're better than you really are. And why am I holding it? Hold on. I've got to get used to my camera being down here now.
Yeah. You're used to it being up on your hat.
Right. Wife bought me a chesty last night. I thought it was a decent deal. It's the GoPro chesty, whatever. 40 bucks at Best Buy.
Yeah, that ain't bad. Especially for GoPro brand.
I'm getting good at catching that
grass.
Cabbage out there. I'm thinking of maybe some type of natural moving bait, natural color.
I know, that's what I'm going with. Are there shad in this?
I've never caught any or seen any, but...
Okay. So their main forage here would be...
Bluegill. Crappie.
I hear crappie is good for trying to build big bass.
I don't know about red ear or no, what's the other one? Crappie? I know there are bluegill and catfish in here. I think I really need to go that far out.
There you go. A little micro. Wants the challenge.
All right. I'm gonna show Adam my setup I got going here. Z-Man chatterbait, 1/2 ounce. Got the Yamamoto Zacco. You say it doesn't have a lot of action. The tail doesn't come through the water.
No, but it's a nice subtle action.
Yeah, that's all it is.
Definitely a good favorite.
All right. You want to try it? It's in the box.
No. Man, I just left that box.
That black and blue one?
That one should be good for you. The one you got on now.
I've caught big ones out of here on a white chatterbait.
Oh yeah.
Caught a 4-pounder. Caught a 4-pounder down in this little cove area down here.
Down here?
Yeah.
A little shallow down there.
Yeah. It's a nice patch of weeds. I don't know which, but I think I got one. Yep. This is like the second cast, maybe third. Just to see where he's at, I'm going to weigh him. I'm betting about 1 pound, maybe 15 ounces. I just know he's bigger than the first one I caught. There you are, a little 15-ouncer. Okay, it is. Come here, buddy. Well, you're bigger than what I thought you were. Oh, he choked it. He absolutely choked it.
Will that be your second three of the year?
He is hooked right in the skin of the roof of his mouth.
That's where you want, boy. Oh yeah.
See where it was hooked right there?
Mm-hmm.
He choked it.
Let me see that one. She's gonna go.
He's bleeding.
3-2.
Is he bleeding from me or is he bleeding just
from? I think just his tail. Might be from bedding.
Could be.
I don't see it running down his side, is it?
Yeah.
No. Yeah, it's just his tail.
So how much you think?
3-2 is a 3-2? Quick guess.
I'm going to say devil's advocate and go 212, 215, but not quite
good. I'm trying to give high hopes for you. I want this to be your second big one of the year.
Trying to be real at 26, 27, 28.
She's chunky, dude.
Yeah, he is.
Hey, that's definitely big fish of the day right there, bud.
Thank you.
Hell yeah.
On that. Can you hold that for me for a second?
Absolutely.
There he is, guys. I'm gonna get her back in the water here. Trying to be more gentle with the bigger fish,
mm-hmm.
You know. You kind of taught me that the other day when a couple of 3 weeks ago out at the church. I don't want you tossing her, you said. Alrighty, I get that.
But I understand sometimes you got to. You don't want to go fall in, you know what I mean? You can't.
Right.
Sometimes you got to toss them. I mean, that's all you
can.
That's
kind of rocky over there.
Yeah. Hell yeah. That chatterbait's going to be a producer for you, bud.
Yeah, so far. Well, you know, back there earlier, I was telling you I was torn about changing. Glad I did. I mean, nothing against that spinnerbait. It's a big producer, too, but this is what they're telling me they want, man.
I'm told the jerkbait and chatterbait are my favorite conventional.
Yep. We got some cloud cover getting ready to come to us. Kind of patchy, but I really like that. Grass out of there. Excuse me. As close as I can to that fountain out there without, I don't want to hit it. I'll get myself at a good angle here that I can maybe I could throw right at it. Deer tracks. I do want to land just on its left. Slowly bring it back. Not in a real big hurry. Letting the bait do its work. I'm not doing anything special to it, just retrieving it back steadily. I know we haven't fished this way yet. Too much. Grass. And I'm gonna go over there and track down my tackle box and my other rod and reel. Bring it with me. Hell, that's almost 6 foot long. But like I said, I threw right out there at the fountain. So now we know where that's at.
Yep.
And this landed just behind the left side of the fountain. That's when it hit the water. All right, now What are you going to give me? Huh? I know you guys are in here. Oh, yeah. You and I hit the same spot. I was already on the retrieve, so you were like right behind it. It's great. I'm ready for one of us to catch a PB today, man. Or both of us.
Yeah. Along the bank.
Oh.
See him? Might be him, I think, anyway.
The old guy?
Yeah.
Ralph, I think is his name, or Kevin.
What's his name?
Did you meet Ralph? I know you met Kevin. Kevin was the last person we met out here.
Okay, yeah, I didn't meet the other one, I know.
I know Gary's met Ralph. This one stopped playing. They're not playing with it anymore. not big by any means, but.
Hey. It ain't no skunk either like I got.
Little chunk, little dinky chunk. I was just sitting here saying that if I didn't catch one pretty soon, I was going to switch off to the worm. And then if that didn't work, I was going to move down there on the other side of the ducks. That's always been a productive spot too. Yeah, that's Ralph. Hey, old man. I still think I'm in lipless territory. gotta say, this trailer has held up good. I am gonna have to tie a lipless back on one of them. Maybe the other one where I just gotta clip it. With a white spare made too. And a couple of those. Yeah, that's what I'm thinking.
Yeah, it'll be close to 2 pounds. Yeah, and you probably hear me stomping on the mud, walking, getting down here to them. Oh, yeah. Nice one.
You got it?
No, he's got it. I'm looking at him. He's holding it up. Wow. I guess it's about 1.5 pounds.
Think?
If that, close to.
Wow.
Hell yeah.
I'm going to say 1 pound,
like
too.
Fourth or fifth fish today, that is, or more. Yep, I ain't got none yet.
1.6, 1.5, 1.5 on the final.
Hell yeah.
All right, thank you.